हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डिजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 21। विद द नेक्स्ट फेज ऑफ कोविड 19 वैक्सीनेशन हैविंग बिगन फॉर द पीपल एज्ड अबाउट 60 इयर्स एंड फॉर दोस हैविंग 45 इयर्स विद हेल्थ इश्यूज, द गवर्नमेंट हैज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड नेसेसरी चेंजेस टू द सिस्टम दैट वाज इन प्लेस ड्यूरिंग इम्यूनाइजेशन ऑफ हेल्थ केयर एंड फ्रंटलाइन वर्कर्स। फॉर द सेकेंड फेज द गवर्नमेंट हैज लॉन्च्ड अ सेकेंड वर्जन ऑफ कोविन ऐप सो दैट यूजर्स कैन रजिस्टर देमसेल्व्स फॉर द वैक्सीनेशन। However, it is likely that the app could be slow or flags of beneficiary would try to register themselves. Reliance Jio has now one of the largest spectrum holding in India. It has 2x10 MHz spectrum in 1800 MHz band and 40 MHz spectrum in 2300 MHz band. Jio is now poised to improve existing 4G services and roll out 5G in future. Spectrum Auction 2021. Day 1 of the spectrum auction is done with a bid worth ₹77,000 crores in 4 distinct rounds for participating bidders, namely Bharti Airtel, Vodafone Idea and Reliance Jio. The latest spectrum auction by the government comes in 5 years after the last auction, which took place in year 2016. Instead of bringing airwaves for 5G networks, the government decided to place auction for 4G networks, specifically in 700 MHz, 800 MHz, 900 MHz, 1800 MHz, 2100 MHz and 2300 and 2500 MHz bands. PhonePe continued to lead the UPI-based digital payments market in India in Feb 2021 with over 970 million transactions. The digital payments firm added that the platform clocked over 1.07 billion total transactions across UPI, cards and wallet on its platform. The National Payments Corporation of India website shows roughly around 2,292 million UPI transactions that worth around 4,25,000 crores took place in India last month. Apple is going to launch their foldable iPhone with an 8-inch display, could be released in the year 2023. Apple is working on an iPhone without any notch, and an iPhone 13 Pro would have a punch-hole display. iPhone Software Edition 3 will launch next year with 5G support and a faster processor. Apple said on Monday all its 270 US stores have been opened, the first time in almost a year after it was forced to shutter several outlets because of this COVID-19 pandemic. The company has become cautious in reopening its retail stores using a team that includes medical experts to make its own call on a country-by-country basis, and sometimes shuttering the stores again when local rules would otherwise allow stores to operate. A man in China has been arrested for swapping an iPhone 12 Pro Max with an apple-flavored yogurt drink. The woman named Liu in China has reported placing the order for an Apple iPhone Pro Max from an Apple's official website. Reliance Jio on Tuesday said it has acquired the right to use spectrum in all 22 circles across India in the latest spectrum auction. The company will pay ₹57,000 crores for the right to use technology against spectrum for over a period of 20 years. And the company also said that very well balanced spectrum for LTE services and future upgradation to 5G technology. Samsung Galaxy A32 4G will launch in India on March 5th. This phone is powered by MediaTek Helio G80 SoC and it has a quad camera setup and back with 64 megapixel primary sensor. It also features 90Hz display refresh rate and packs around 5000mAh battery. The price would be ₹21,999 for 6GB RAM and 128GB storage. The phone is expected to come in 4GB and 8GB variants as well, but the prices of these variants are not known yet. Redmi Note 10 series launches later this week when it is unveiled. It will come with a feature that it gives an edge over several of its competitors. While we already know that new Redmi Note 10 series will have an AMOLED display, and Xiaomi has now confirmed that it will also have a 120Hz refresh rate. An AMOLED display with 120Hz refresh rate is something you would usually find on flagship phones. Even budget flagship phones with an AMOLED display usually come with 60Hz refresh rate. So this is a big deal, the feature as confirmed by official Xiaomi Twitter account earlier today. Realme held the 2021 Realme Camera Innovation event, and one of the big news released during the event is that Realme 8 Pro will debut with 108 megapixel camera. The camera is positioned to output super images that will have balanced overall exposure with vivid colors, sharp details in both bright and dark conditions to a new smart ISO feature. The sensor will have a support for 9-in-1 pixel binning and ISO cell plus. Oppo has finally confirmed the launch of the F19 Pro series in India on March 8th with a teaser on Flipkart. The company also announces that it has signed Bollywood actor Varun Dhawan as a brand ambassador for the F series that was already almost confirmed with the last teaser. Oppo F19 Pro Plus 5G and Oppo F19 Pro will be launched in India with Dimensity 800U and Helio P95 SoC. Poly creates a premium audio and video product so you can have your best meeting anywhere, anytime and every time. Their headsets, video and audio conferencing products, desk phones, analytics software and service are beautifully designed and engineered to connect people with incredible clarity. Poly unveiled the PolySync family, a new line of smart USB and Bluetooth speakers. Boat T-Rebel, a new range of headphones and earphones, has been launched by Indian audio accessories company. The product range includes a wired, wireless, true wireless, stereo, earphones and headphones. All these products in the range are offered in new color option with price starting from ₹399 and all going up to ₹2999. Google is experimenting with a new feature in Chrome that will make it easier to access browser features and settings with a simple few keystrokes. This new feature called Commander is currently available in Chrome Canary 91. Google described it as a text interface to common Chromium functionalities. The purpose of the Commander is to let you quickly execute various browsing actions without having to remember or press awkward key combination. It acts as a universal search bar for all browser shortcuts, menus, settings, and more. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.